Hello, it's Carla Clayton, the Wellness Lady, and welcome to Wellness Lady TV. My passion is sharing tips to help you create a healthier life, home and business, one step at a time. And today my topic is about the science of losing weight and keeping it off. But before we start, I want to tell you what's motivated me to tell you about this topic. I just got back from a science symposium about this topic. And I was listening to a top researcher in this field. And anyway, I just took away, I found it very motivating for myself, but I want to back this up and tell you that many people who work in my industry in helping people get healthier, helping people lose weight, we know that most people are not really motivated by the truth and the facts and the science behind things. They're really more motivated by before and after photos, anecdotal things, and you know, just hearing stories. So, I mean, I have plenty of that to share, but today I just wanted to let you know that truly I am kind of a science geek. So this goes way back for me. I have always loved science all the way back to elementary school. And my favorite high school teacher was a physics teacher, Mr. Hall. Oh my gosh, he just made science so fun and interesting. I loved it. And in high school, I took the ASVAB. It's this test you can take to see your aptitude for maybe being in the military, because at one time I thought I might want to do that. And I scored like 98th percentile in the area of like technical stuff. Who knew? I didn't know. I thought I was very creative. I love art and things like that. So I don't know. I got one of these brains that's all over the place. So then I went off to college, and my favorite teacher in college was my astronomy teacher, Dr. Marks. And he, I took both classes from him, Astronomy 1 and Astronomy 2. So my favorite TV show is The Big Bang Theory. Okay. So when I went to this science symposium and our scientists that were speaking came out on stage and we're all like standing up, giving a standing ovation, I just smiled to myself. I said, I'm amongst my people. And so this video today, this episode today is for those of you that love science and want to know the science behind losing weight and keeping it off. Because here's the truth. The truth is that 95% of all people who go on a diet gain that weight back in 1 year. Now, if you hear that statistic, I mean, you can probably think about people you know who've done that. You can think about yourself if you've been through that. So it's something that is disturbing. It really is. So what I'm going to share with you today is how you cannot be in that cycle, because come on, people, diets don't work. Lifestyle works. And even within lifestyle, there are certain things, if you understand the science behind it, will motivate you to make those choices that are going to help you. I mean, I'm motivated by the science. All right. I am. I'm skeptical of the before and after pictures. I am. Okay. So I want to share with you, one of our speakers was Dr. Wayne Westcott. He has a PhD in exercise physiology. He is one of the leading researchers in this area of weight loss, muscle tone, metabolism, all this good stuff. And he comes out of Quincy College, and he has been doing studies on this for a number of years. I know I've followed him for probably at least 10 years, maybe more, his studies that he's had. And he's published in clinical exercise journals. So very reputable science. So I just want to give you that. So then I want to share with you just a few of the points that he shared with us at the conference that I think will help you to be able to motivate yourself to just do some very simple things that could make a difference in maintaining your healthy weight and keeping it off. So first of all, this is something that we need to understand, just the background. When we turn 50, and I'm in that category, and if we don't exercise, if we're sedentary, living a sedentary lifestyle, we begin to lose 5 to 10 pounds of muscle every decade. Now, muscle is important because that is what powers our metabolism. So with that, also, if you lose that much muscle, you're losing 3% of your resting metabolic rate. So that's that metabolism we're talking about. That's the ability to burn calories. So imagine your efficiency now is you're burning calories at 3% less, okay? So now you have to eat less. And imagine doing this every decade. And then the thing that happens is when we're losing muscle, that contributes to bone loss. So, you know, as women, we know as we get older, osteopenia, osteoporosis, these are very serious things we don't want. So what is the solution? The solution is exercise, right? A healthy diet, a healthy lifestyle. So I want to give you one more statistic. Less than 5% of Americans do the recommended 30 minutes of walking a day. Less than 5%. And that's also true with nutrition. It's like mind blowing how many people are not eating or getting their RDAs just or eating the recommended servings of vegetables. So let's talk about the area that Dr. Westcott specializes in is rebuilding that muscle, building muscle as we age, as we're in our 50s and up. Hey, this applies to you if you're younger, but especially those of us in our 50s and up. By age 50, we now require 25% more than the recommended daily allowance for protein because our assimilation of protein actually reduces as we age. If we're trying to build muscle, which is going to build our metabolism, we need 50% more protein. So let's talk about the next thing. What is a balanced exercise program that has been proven to work? And Dr. Westcott's study at Quincy College, they have found that just 2 times a week of doing 20 minutes of aerobic and 20 minutes of strength and resistance training can make a huge impact. Just 2 times a week. Now, I don't know about you, but that seems manageable. I've been going to a personal trainer once a week to make sure I'm getting in once a week, but I see I need to up it to 2 times. So I'm going to work on doing the second set on my own. And if I have to, if I can't motivate myself to do it, then I'm going to have to pay my trainer to have that appointment and make me do it, right? But here's the thing. So we're talking about the assimilation of protein. So Dr. Westcott's study proved that we assimilate that protein best right after a workout. So in his study, he recommends a protein supplement shake after the workout. And that's what they did. So he did this study over 6 months with this group of people over 50. And this is what he said blew him away. Because the problem with dieting, lifestyle changes is it's really hard to sustain people in those, to keep going, to not give up. And so in his group, he had an 83% completion rate. And he says that's because the program was so easy to follow. And in a regular diet study, only 50% of people can complete the programs. So that speaks well for the program. So you can probably guess at the end, I'm going to tell you a little bit more how you could participate in a program that they were using, right? So stick around for that. But for right now, let's talk about what were the results. So 83% completed the study. In that group, and here's what they did. They did the twice a week exercise. They did the protein supplement daily, and they did a nutritional supplement program, a sensible one. In that group, they lost an average of 14 pounds over the 6 months. And hey, guys, we don't want to lose weight quick. That's not sustainable. It needs to be slow and sustained. Secondly, they gained, and what's most important is they gained 4 pounds of muscle. So that increased their, you know, their resting metabolic rate. And they also they had a decrease of 5.75% of body fat. And isn't that what we want? We want to lose fat. So this is the only program that has a clinical study that we know of that actually proves that you can lose all fat, no muscle, actually gain muscle, which boosts your metabolism. Now, if that intrigues you, then stick around because I'm going to tell you a little bit more about that. Now, I want to say that after he did the 6-month study, because, you know, a lot of people show weight loss, but it's about, can it be sustained? Can you keep it off? So he continued the study and he had, it wasn't structured anymore. He had people that were in that program who signed up to continue with just doing exercise on their own, this same program, and continuing with the shake and the vitamins. And here's what happened. And he said it surprised him and everybody else involved in the study that they continued to lose weight and they continued to add muscle. Matter of fact, they gained 3 pounds of muscle and they lost 2 pounds of fat. And then he said, so a lot of times, and I know I talk to a lot of people and they're like, I'm going to do this on my own. I don't need that shake and that strip that you're always talking about. I don't need that. Fine. So he says there's a comparison study out there where that he worked on, and they had a nutritionist only come in. They didn't use the shake and strip, and they just, the nutritionist said, here's what you need to eat. Here's the healthy plan. They did the same exercise plan. Their completion rate was only 60% compared to the 83%. And, you know, it was just really hard for people to sustain and keep up with. So if you've tried all those other things, I want to invite you to consider that it's not just calories, it's not just exercise, but it's very good nutrition, and it's getting the nutrition at the right time. And it can be so simple as a strip and a shake that I talk about all the time. And so what I want to do is I want to invite you to do a 30-day challenge with me. We call it the Prove It Challenge because I want you to prove it to yourself that in 30 days with a very simple program, exercise 2 times a week, do the strip and shake. If you don't feel amazing, if you don't begin to see weight loss, if you don't, you know, aren't just completely satisfied, you get a refund for your investment into the program. So if you want details on that, just drop an emoji below or message me. And also, I want to share with you that I do have a before picture. I'm going to show you before and after picture. This is one of the girls on my team who she took the Prove It Challenge. I'm going to see if I can share this. I got a lot going on my screen here. Let's see. How do we do this? Share. And there you go. This is Stacy. I hope you're seeing it. This is Stacy, and she accepted the challenge. She started out with 30 days, and then she just kept on going. She's been doing this for 2.5 years now, and she has lost 70 pounds, and she's kept it off. She's had highs and lows. You know, life happens in between, you know, doing the program, so it's not been perfect on the program, but look at that. And she says she feels so amazing. She has so much energy and she absolutely loves this program. So I wanted to share that with you. I wanted to share, let's see if I can pull up. That wasn't too bad. Let's see if I can pull up another one. Let's see. Well, I thought I had it accessible here. Yep, here we go. Let's see. I'm going to share the screen for this one, I think. Got to get in the right place and share. And here we go. This is someone else that took the Prove It Challenge. Matter of fact, this is one of my very first weight loss clients when I started focusing on helping people lose weight. And Deb has been on this program since 2012. And she was able to lose over 100 pounds. She's been able to keep most of that off over this long period of time. She says she feels great. Her numbers, this is what is so amazing, is her numbers, like she no longer has trouble with blood pressure, triglycerides, all that before she started the program, very high. And she's got her life back and she's so vibrant and healthy and happy now. And so to me, I think that's the greatest thing. So I absolutely love, I'm passionate about helping people make these small changes. And so I want to invite you to work with me on helping you get healthy. And hey, maybe it's not for you, but maybe you know somebody that's really looking for, I mean, like I said, I pay a personal trainer to help me get the exercise in, because for me, that's hard for me. I need that extra motivation. I need the appointment. I need someone to check in with me. So if you or someone you know is like that about the nutrition side, then I invite you to reach out to me or hop over to my website, wellnesslady.com. I've got lots of resources there for you, as well as I have the wellness project that you can be a part of, that where I archive all my articles and videos and things like that. So be sure to check all that out. Thanks so much for watching, and have an awesome and amazing day.